up again for already the fifth time this season. They'll try to keep it rolling against Bowling Green today. Alumni Stadium in Chestnut Hill, Massachusetts, where today the seventh-ranked Eagles of Boston College look to keep their perfect season intact. They're going to face the Falcons of Bowling Green, 3-1 on the season, and hoping to pull the upset. Hi again, everybody. Welcome to Alumni Stadium. Alongside my regular partner, Larry Coker, I'm Clay Matvick, and we've got a special guest in the booth today, Gerard Phelan, former BC wide receiver. He's going into the Boston College Sports Hall of Fame this week. Welcome, and we could see a lot of passes today.
Thank you. You know, I'll tell you, the quarterbacks on both sides are just outstanding. They're going to spread the field in formation. They're going to throw the ball to the receivers looking for a good run, and there's going to be a premium on coverage and points today.
Of course, Matt Ryan on everybody's Heisman radar now, Larry. Both of these defenses know what's coming, but the trick is trying to stop it.
Clay, there's going to be probably 100-plus passes. A defensive coordinator's nightmare. And both these quarterbacks, they're completing nearly 70% of their passes. The key is pressure on the quarterbacks and, again, making sure that they tackle well in space.
All right, gentlemen, Boston College has won the toss. And they've deferred, so Bowling Green will start with the football here today. Boston College. We have Billy Bennett kick it off. And returning Roger Williams for Bowling Green. And we're underway at Chestnut Hill. And this is Williams from inside his 5-yard line, starting it back. Out over the 20, makes a little spin, and then he stood up and hit hard at the 20-yard line, an 18-yard return for Williams, and the tackle made by Robert Francois for Boston College. Here's a look at Tyler Sheehan, making his fifth career start today, averaging 326 yards passing per game, has 10 touchdowns, 4 interceptions. First down and 10, first play of the game here for Bowling Green. And, of course, he wants to throw. Has a receiver in and out of the hands of Corey Partridge. Here's the Falcons' leading receiver from last season, Jolon Dunbar, in on the coverage. Backs and receivers for Bowling Green. Freddie Barnes, a sophomore from the Chicago area. He's been their number one receiver. But a lot of guys get the ball in this offense. Sheehan had 8 different receivers last week. Up front, 3 fifth-year seniors. Number 78, Corey Lichtensteiger, is making his 40th consecutive start today. Second and 10. Looking to the left, throws, and that's a little bit too tall for the intended receiver, and it's incomplete. Tyrone Pronti was the guy he was trying to hit. DeJuan Tribble on defense. The Eagles got healthier this week. Senior defensive end Nick Larkin out since week 2 with a knee injury, back today. The linebackers Pruitt, Dunbar, and Herzlick. Herzlick leads the team in tackles for loss, and the defensive backs, you just saw DeJuan Tribble. He's got 14 career interceptions. Third down and 10. Sheehan over the middle. Has a receiver. It is Barnes. Out over the 30. Has enough for the first down. And that's exactly what Bowling Green is going to try to do today, guys. Pick up first downs. Keep the offense out on the field so they can keep Matt Ryan off the field.
Well, again, we're talking about tackling and run after catch. Again, a missed tackle here. You've got to make that tackle. If you make that tackle, so now it's a fourth down. It's a punting situation.
So now first down and 10 from the 35. They swing it out to the running back. Ball comes loose. Jumping on it is Willie Jeter. Jeter had it and then was leveled by Jolon Dunbar. And the ball almost came loose to where it was turned over.
Well, they moved Jolon Dunbar out on the side to pick up the swing pass, and Boston College is doing a real good job on coverage out there, and Sheehan's doing a nice job finding the open man. This time BC was just up to the challenge.
That's a great hit by Dunbar, and they ruled it a catch and a fumble.
Empty backfield. You'll see that a lot today for Bowling Green. Sheehan kicked out of the pocket, rolls to his right, throws on the run, and this looks like it's going to be enough for another Bowling Green first down. And it was Willie Jeter. He is a running back, but the Falcons have basically abandoned the run. They led the MAC in rushing last year. That's not going to happen this year. These running backs catch passes now.
They do, and they run with it very well. So you have to be very careful if you're a linebacker getting a one-on-one with Geeter. He's quite a good back, and he's going to make a few plays today.
Basically abandoned the run. I have seen no runs. They totally abandoned the run.
Inside handoff to Willie Geeter. That's going to be a four-yard pickup. And it's going to be a warm day here today at Chestnut Hill. 80 degrees at kickoff, light winds, and very muggy. It's going to be a factor here, Troy.
It is, but we are in New England, so the weather can change at any time.
That's true.
Thanks for this breeze down there.
Yeah, a little overcast. They're going to have to chase these quarterbacks around. These linemen are going to get a little bit winded.
Sheehan out of the gun. On second down, Cox's arm now. He's going to try and run for the first down. Has it. And I'll tell you what, he is moving this offense.
Yeah, he surely is. And, you know, the thing about Sheehan is that it does have some pretty good speed. We were watching the Michigan State tape, and we had watched him outrun a few linebackers for 15 yards on a couple of occasions. So he offers this element to the Bowling Green offense.
He does. He's got to work on this slide, though. I tell you, it's a little bit of an ugly slide, but it's effective. He doesn't get hit. Smart play by the quarterback.
I'll tell you what, Sheehan really has meshed with first-year offensive coordinator Mick McCall. He throws it out again to Geeter. Not a lot of operating room here, and Dunbar wraps him up. It's going to be a one-yard gain for Geeter. But the new offensive coordinator is Mick McCall. In his first year on the job, he was the quarterback coach the last 4 years, but these guys are clicking on all cylinders.
He's got them going. I mean, they were a rushing team last year, and this year they're throwing the ball, and they're throwing the ball number one in the MAC, and they only played 4 games compared to everybody else of 5 games.
There are a lot of Eagles around that play also.
On second down and 9, Sheehan, it is complete. It's going to be a couple yards short of the first down, but a nice catch there by Tyrone Pronti, the sophomore out of Maple Heights, Ohio. It's going to bring up 3rd and short.
Well, again, as I said, this is a defensive coordinator's nightmare. He's buying so much time, there's no way to get pressure on him. And finally, late, that was about an 8-yard completion. Now it's 3rd and 2. Very makeable, obviously.
On 3rd downs this season, the Falcons clicking along at about 44%. Again, they need to make the 1st downs today. And talking with their coaching staff, the whole goal today is keep the ball out of Matt Ryan's hands. Big 3rd down play here. And they've got the 1st down. That quick passing offense is gelling so far here today. Corey Partridge on that reception.
Well, this is a classic. Twins to the right. They run the outside receiver deep to run off the corner, and then they run a little out route up underneath it. They only needed a couple yards, and they got about 3.
That's just somewhat like a run. It's a very, very high percentage play, and they treat it somewhat like a run.
Spread offense has it 1st and 10. Sheehan under pressure, being chased. Now off his back foot, throws it away. It's a pretty smart play for the sophomore Sheehan just to get rid of it. Gerard, when you're a wide receiver in this offense and you know that they're throwing just about every down, what's that like?
Well, it gets tiring, that's for sure. But you just got to stay focused. And I guess one of the biggest challenges is you have 5 receivers on the field, so you have to expect the ball to come to you every time, even though it may not.
Sheehan already 6 for 9, 36 yards. And this is the 10th pass attempt already. Corey Partridge in the flat, trying to pick up the 1st down. Looks like he's about 1.5 yards short. Call it a 9-yard gain for Partridge on that play. He is one of the go-to guys along with Freddie Barnes.
Well, Boston College doesn't need to panic. They're doing a good job really swarming the football. They put pressure on the quarterback, on Sheehan at times. Again, they just got to stay with what they're doing. Bowling Green is going to make some plays.
I don't think the Falcons are intimidated. You know, they've already beaten Minnesota. They've played well with Michigan State. There's a new quarterback in there. It's Anthony Turner. We were told this might happen. He's got some good legs, but he stopped there. Does not pick up the 3rd down conversion. DeJuan Dribble steps up from his quarterback stop and drops him about 1 yard short of where he needed to be.
Again, this is obviously going to be a run. This is a great tackle. Yeah, I think this is what Boston College wants to do and what they need to do.
Well, Tribble seems to be making the big plays for Boston College this year, and this can't be bigger. You know, Bowling Green goes down and stuffs this in the end zone. It gets a Mo all on their side.
40-yard attempt for Vervillo, the field goal kicker. And he's got it. Sanisha Vervillo, now 7-for-9 on field goal attempts. And that's a 40-yarder to put Bowling Green on top, 3-0. Good start for the Falcons.
Well, we talked about this. This is a very good football team, the number one team in the MAC, and not a lot of folks have heard about them. And they're coming in here sky high to play the number 6-ranked Boston College Eagles. So you expect that they're going to bring their best game on their first series.
Well, yeah, also, too, you know, they're not intimidated. They've played in big stadiums. They played Michigan State tough. I saw the tape yesterday. It was a 21-17 game going in the fourth quarter. They beat Minnesota on the road, so they expect this. They love to play big-time games like this.
There's Greg Brandon now in his fifth year as the head coach. He's trying to get the Falcons back to the postseason. They had back-to-back bowl games in 03 and 04, and they've been shut out of the postseason since then. Greg really thinks that he's got a pretty good team. Things are working pretty well right now for the squad.
Well, I'll bet a lot of the folks here that are fans for Boston College are very surprised that Bowling Green was able to come down out and move the ball like they did. And, you know, coming up with 3 points is going to really give them a lot of confidence. Now Boston College is going to have to come out and score on their possession.
I think that's a win for Boston College to hold them to a field goal attempt and 3 points. You're right. Bowling Green moved the ball well, but they're going to need to score 7 points. The threes are not going to win it going against Matt Ryan and the Eagle offense.
Jeff Smith and Brandon Robinson back deep. Smith is an interesting story. He was cleared to play this weekend after sitting 6 weeks with a concussion, a pretty good kick return. That's his first of the year. It's short, just 6 yards in that pickup, but he's happy to be back out on the field. Now let's take a look at Matt Ryan for the first time here today. Of course, this could be a Heisman Trophy winner for this guy, already over 1,500 passing yards.
Well, that's a huge start for Matt Ryan. He's been a great player ever since he's been playing here. He's a special talent. With a special head on his shoulders. That's what's so impressive about Matt Ryan, and a great leader. He's a tremendous leader. And I'm going to go back to that, Clay, later on in the broadcast about his leadership.
He's had 2 400-yard passing games already this year. Run on that play. Andre Callender, the short pickup. Well, it's not just about Ryan in this Boston College offense. He has plenty of help, including Brandon Robinson, who has 3 touchdown grabs. And on that line, Gosder Sherilis, the senior left tackle, Bowling Green D coordinator, Mike Ward told us this week, he's probably one of the best in the country.
He's an outstanding presence out there, and he's protecting Matt Ryan's exposed side. And I'll tell you, I wouldn't want to line up across from him on a hot day like today.
No, he's 6'7", 319. Here's Ryan. Throws it out. Callender has it up for the first down. He's dragged down from behind. But not before he gets the first down. A gain of 9, and they'll move the chains. The Falcons on defense, they'll try to get pressure on Ryan today, all day. Dyrell Briggs has 15 career sacks. The linebackers in secondary have been spectacular in the first 4 games. Dozier, he's a converted safety. And in the secondary, Antonio Smith, in his 3rd year as a starter at corner, this defense has already forced 14 turnovers this season. On first down, Ryan throws it out. Got it out to the tight end spot.
Again, that's a good job by Bowling Green, because, again, it was a catch, it was completion, but a very short gain. And you can live with that if you're the Bowling Green Falcons.
That was Ryan Thompson, the 6'4 senior out of Akron. This guy is a competitor. Look at the season numbers, 11 touchdowns already. He's been picked off 5 times. Now, last year, he played on a broken left foot, and everyone was saying, boy, I wonder how good this guy's going to be when he's actually healthy. We're getting an idea this year.
He's special.
Pocket, plenty of time to throw. Got it out close to the 40-yard line. The receiver, Rich Gannell. He has been a regular in this receiving rotation this year.
In this type of offense, we have to complete a lot of passes. Accuracy is absolutely critical, and timing is absolutely critical. If you're going to get a good run out of a wide receiver, if you put the ball right on the mark, it gives them an opportunity to make a move and perhaps make something bigger out of it.
And probably Matt Ryan. There's nobody better in the country than Matt Ryan doing exactly what you're talking about, Gerard. Great job to shell across. Steve Logan, the offensive coordinator, has always done a great job with the shallow crossing routes.
Ryan already 3-for-3 throwing. This is his 4th attempt. Another completion. Got it out to Ryan Thompson again. He steps out. At about the 45-yard line, a pickup of 6 and another first down for BC.
You know, it's right back at you. We watch Bowling Green execute flawlessly on their way down the field to get into field goal position, and Boston College is volleying it right back at them.
This looks like surgery. They're pretty good. They look good. They throw, they catch. Their protection's outstanding. Both teams.
Going to run here. It's Andre Callender. Short pickup on first down. We'll call it five. That's the team's leading rusher right there. And he has shared the load with L.V. Whitworth the last 3 years. But in this new West Coast system, Gerard, it's really Callender that gets the lion's share of the carries.
Yeah, he really does. He's got a 5.1 yard per carry for Boston College, which really takes a lot of pressure off of Matt Ryan. Now, they don't run the ball nearly as much as they throw the ball, but it's good to know that you can go to a back that can get you positive yards on every carry.
We go on second and six. We'll play action. Ryan backpedaling, drops it off short to Callender. Now trying to pick his way, finds a seam, and there he goes. Andre Callender to the end zone, touchdown. 51 yards to the end zone for Callender, and Boston College has taken the lead.
That's a great play, and great play by Callender. I just started to say, he's not an explosive type player like they've had at running back before. Looked pretty explosive right there. He ran the ball well, made a great job running the football, and good job blocking downfield.
Well, the coaches have always known that he can do this type of thing to you. He looks like he's dead right here, and then a few nifty moves and an acceleration, and he's gone. I tell you, everybody that we talked to at Bowling Green had said, we got to prevent the big play from Boston College. If we keep the ball away from him, we'll have some success. So this is an absolute killer for him.
Opinavichus with the point after. And BC has a 7-3 lead over Bowling Green at home. Callender from 51 yards away takes it into the end zone for the touchdown. And the seventh-ranked team in the country, new to the top 10, hoping to stay there. Try not to get upset today against MAC opponent Bowling Green.
You have to be here.
No curb appeal. Hate the color. Oh, honey, this is it.
What you got there is an infestation.
A lot of life happens in your car. Conoco and 76 quality Pro Clean gasolines help clean your engine as you drive.
The pink wasn't so bad.
So you can focus on more important things. Conoco and 76 quality Pro Clean gasolines.
Nissan Titan is a strategic vision total quality award leader. It's also the only truck tough enough to deliver college football's most coveted award. The Heisman, brought to you by the Nissan Titan.
Anything you buy at the Home Depot could turn into four seats to the Super Bowl and the Pro Bowl and the NFL Draft. Buy select products and you double your entries. So enter today and see what happens. Only at the Home Depot.
Coker and Gerard Phelan, I'm Clay Matvick, back in Boston. BC has taken the lead 7-3. There is Andre Callender, a 7-play, 81-yard drive. He took it in from 51 yards away on the run. And how about Matt Ryan, 4-for-4, throwing the football on that drive?
That's what everybody's looking for out of Matt. And, you know, it doesn't matter whether he's picked off and they take it in for a touchdown or whether he's 4 for 4. He goes out on the field with the same determination.
Bowling Green, this is Roger Williams. Good return out over the 45, finally brought down. And it's a 36-yard return for Williams. Good field position for the Falcons. Let's go to the studio and Mike Gleason.
And Clay, West Virginia in the dome, and Syracuse striking early.
Yeah, how would you like to be a defender? And the pitch man is Big Owen Schmidt, 250 pounds, his first touchdown of the year for West Virginia.
7-0 Mountaineers. And how about Butch Davis facing the Canes? Well, Anthony Elzey breaks one for 39 yards. And North Carolina at home on top of the Canes, 7-0, Clay.
All right, guys, thank you very much. We've got a penalty flag down on that last play. A good return by Williams. Ball is spotted right now at the 46, but let's see what the flag is about.
Personal foul, number 11, on the receiving team. 15-yard penalty, first down.
That's against Pete Winovich. And so that'll bring it back inside the 30-yard line at the 29. Well, we knew that the ball was going to be in the air a lot. Already 10 passes in this game for Tyler Sheehan.
Yeah, you're going to see a lot more. Obviously, that's their philosophy. That's what they do. They're good at it. They know that's their best opportunity to win. Get the more talented Boston College defense. Get them in space. Make them miss a tackle. Make first downs. And you can see what Boston College can do once they get the football. That's a good philosophy that Bowling Green has.
There's still an issue down on the field with the officials, but it looks like they've got it worked out.
We were talking to Coach Baziana, the defensive coordinator for Boston College, yesterday, and he was saying in his preparation for Bowling Green, you know, what is this like to prepare for this type of offense where they just throw the ball over the field, they got five wide receivers out there. He said it's like preparing for the wishbone. You see it once or twice every year, and it proposes a unique challenge for the defensive coordinator and the defensive players to adjust.
That's unique, all right. On first down at 10, they've got it at their own 31. Here's Bowling Green going back to work. Sheehan looking to his right, pressured, and down he goes, sacked from behind. And it's Albright. Alex Albright, the left defensive end, who has really asserted himself as a true freshman from a year ago, now a solid vet off that edge.
Well, they got to put some pressure on him with the front four. And that's going to be the challenge for these guys down here. If they can get to Sheehan early, that's going to throw him off his rhythm and have a good impact.
It's a loss of 7 on the play.
It's a good job by Frank Spaziano, defensive coordinator, designing a blitz that was not protected.
Sheehan drops it underneath. And that's Pete Winovich who gets some of it back. It's a gain of 11. But still third and fairly long here to go. Now, when you say that blitz was unprotected, what exactly do you mean, Coach?
Well, Frank Spaziani and the defensive staff, they will go in on Sunday nights and look at their protections and say, listen, this blitz, I think they'll have trouble protecting this blitz. This can get pressure on the quarterback. And that was a great job on that sack.
Now 3rd and 7. Forced out. Sheehan's going to take it himself. Has a lane and has enough for the first down. Well, Sheehan is on pace to break some school passing records, but you can see he's pretty nimble on his feet too, Gerard.
Well, this time he's in a track race with one of the defensive linemen. So, you know, you got to figure that he's going to win this one. But the thing that I like about him is that he's got a wonderful presence of mind. There was nobody open downfield. The coverage was outstanding. And rather than try and force it in there on a third and medium term, he decided to take what Boston College gave him, and that was a wide open left flank.
And he knew what he needed for a first down too, Gerard. He didn't come up short. He came up a yard to his favor.
Sheehan. Complete on first down to Corey Partridge. That's going to be a pickup of 13 yards on the play. Mike McLaughlin, the middle linebacker, was able to bring him down, but not before he gets the first down. And Partridge missed most of that Minnesota game, the first game of the season, and then all of the Michigan State game with an ankle sprain, but he's obviously okay now.
This is just organized chaos in the secondary, but one thing that I like about what Boston College is doing defensively is they're containing the run after the catch.
Sheehan Receiver comes back to the ball. A good pickup on first down. Freddie Barnes there. Looks like he's got eight. But there is a penalty flag down.
It may have been an illegal formation by Bowling Green.
This is textbook for the receiver. Freddie Barnes was a quarterback in high school. They recruited him as an athlete and made him a wideout. And he came back to the football. There's every quarterback out there is always saying to the wide receivers, come back to the ball when I throw it. I know the defensive back is, you got to beat him back to the ball. And Freddie did a real nice job catching that. It almost gave him enough space to break it.
Got an ACC crew today. That's referee Walter Davenport, but still aren't sure exactly what they're going to call here.
Illegal formation. Offense, number 71. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
That's Drew Nystrom, the left tackle, a fifth-year senior out of Crystal Lake, Illinois. And that's one thing about this Bowling Green offense. They've got a lot of veteran leadership up front. Three fifth-year seniors. A rare mistake there by Nystrom. But that's been part of the reason that that passing game has been so good for the Falcons.
Yeah, they're also real sizable up there as well. And, you know, Drew has got to be thinking, okay, Albright's beat me once. I think that time he just cheated back a little bit and the referee caught him.
First down, 15. Shea. Again comes underneath. Barnes. And it's a pickup of about 7 yards on the play. Let's go to Mike in Charlotte.
And the Fighting Illini of Illinois knocks out Penn State. Now they take aim against number 5, Wisconsin.
Yeah, Rashad Mendenhall takes the pitch from Juice Wilb. Look at number 17, Langford, right there for Wisconsin. He's out of position. That enabled Mendenhall to get to the end zone. That's his 9th one of the year.
Illinois on top. Syracuse came right back against the Mountaineers. Curtis Brinkley up and over. Tied in the Dome, 7-7. Play.
All right, Mike, thank you very much. How about that Illini? There's another catch by Barnes. Driven out of bounds. It's going to bring up third down and about 7 here for Bowling Green. But Illinois, you know, they were actually the favorites this week going into a game against 5th-ranked Wisconsin. That's how much Ron Zook has turned things around here this year.
Ron Zook didn't want to be favored. He was upset that he was favored. He wanted to continue to be the underdog, which I don't blame him.
That Aurelius Ben, Juice Williams, Rashard Mendenhall's show has been fun to watch this year. Take a look at Bowling Green on third down on the season again, clicking along at about 44%. Pressure. And out of bounds. Herzlick put a lot of pressure there on Sheehan, and Bowling Green is probably in a position now where they're out of field goal range, unlike last time.
Yeah, what happened here was they rushed 4 guys, but it was a linebacker and 3 down linemen. They pulled the nose guard out to account for the back coming out of the backfield, so they couldn't get that intermediate pass for the 5 or 6 yards. It was a very good call on defense.
Nick Iovanelli, the punter, coming on for the first time here today. And there you see DeJuan Tribble back to return. Tribble at the 10. He's going to watch this sail over his head and into the end zone. Boy, Tribble just laid a hit on Brandon Robinson down there at the 5-yard line. Check that Antonio Smith. No penalty on the play. 7-3 our score. Under 4 minutes to go here in the opening quarter at Chestnut Hill. Ryan gets the ball next.
Oh, game day.
Yeah, like your breakfast.
Bergwood, your new car's rolling.
It's not stolen. I just bought it.
It's gonna hit that truck!
There's no need to swear!
Oh. Hot car, huh?
It's on fire.
Do you have new car replacement? Call Allstate to sign up today. Are you in good hands?
I move right, you move left. You slow down, and I speed up. Don't worry if you don't know all the steps. I'm happy to take the lead in this dance. This is basketball, and this is who I am. NBA Live 08, rated E for everyone. EA Sports, it's in the game.
The Super Bowl is the ultimate prize. Now, for the first time ever, Sports Illustrated is celebrating each Super Bowl winning team with this one-of-a-kind collector's package. You'll get your choice of any of the 41 amazing DVDs chronicling your favorite Super Bowl winners' championship season. Relive history with rare footage, highlights, and powerful interviews from NFL Films' America's Game Collection. Choose your team and Super Bowl season and get the DVD free with your paid subscription to SI. Plus, when you use your credit card, you'll also get a framed reprint of the original Sports Illustrated cover commemorating your team's Super Bowl victory. Each iconic cover is a true classic. Both are free with your paid subscription to SI. All 41 champions are available. Go to ordersi.com and order now. Remember what it meant. Now, recapture what it means with these two great gifts.
Call 1-800-251-5200 or visit ordersi.com.
Only ESPNU Coaches Spotlight gets you the info on the top college football teams. ESPNU Coaches Spotlight, Tuesdays at 1, only on ESPNU.
ESPNU College Football is presented by Allstate. Are you in good hands? So after a Bowling Green drive stalls out, Matt Ryan and the Boston College offense set to go back to work. 7-3. The Eagles on top, under 4 minutes to go here in the opening quarter. There's a look at Ryan, the senior out of Exton, Pennsylvania. He's going to hand off here on first down to Andre Callender. Pick up a 5 on the play. Now Ryan, third place on Boston College all-time passing yardage list behind Doug Flutie and Glenn Foley. And of course, later on in the show, we hope to get Doug Flutie on the air with us live. Of course, you guys are going to forever be connected on that Hail Mary play from 84. But you know, are the comparisons that are being made to about Matt Ryan to other great players like Schaub and Flutie and some of the other guys like Hasselbeck, are those fair?
I think they're fair at this point. You know, the team's 5-0 for the first time in a long time. He's not only got the statistics, but one of the things that Steve Logan likes the most about him, the offensive coordinator for BC, is that he really is a true leader. He does all the leadership things. As a matter of fact, when they change coaching staff, here's a senior who's, you know, competing for All-American honors, the Heisman Trophy, that sort of thing. And he goes out, gets the team together, and says, okay, Tom O'Brien is leaving. We're going to have a new coach, but we got to band together here. We got to work because we can affect what we have control over, and that is playing and making plays on the field.
On first and 10, Ryan. Man, he's perfect today throwing the football. This time, it's complete to Justin Jarvis, a sophomore out of Bloomfield, Connecticut. Now, Jeff Jagosinski, when he got the job here, coach, was blessed. Not only did he inherit a quarterback like Matt Ryan, but he inherited a lot of seniors, too.
Yeah, a little bit similar to the team I inherited at the University of Miami. There's 17 seniors, a lot of fifth-year seniors here, and very talented players, plus a great quarterback in Matt Ryan. And I think Jeff knows that. His personality is different than Tom O'Brien. Tom did a great job here, but I think this personality is different, and it's fit in well.
Callender over the right side. Good pickup on first down. That's one thing about this West Coast offense. If the passing is working, it sure opens up some running lanes.
It really does. And Boston College is doing a very nice job up front controlling the line of scrimmage. If you get a look at this, you can see that there's a surge 2 or 3 yards back before the back even gets touched.
So look at the total yards. Boston College certainly passed well today to start. Ryan, a perfect 7 for 7 through the air, but they go back to Callender here, and he's got enough for the first down. He's down at the 42, a 4-yard pickup before the weak side linebacker, John Hainline, is able to corral him.
You know, back to Coach Jags, Jeff Jagosinski. I think, again, his philosophy is different. Tom O'Brien did a great job here. They went to 8 straight bowl games here. That's a record. Won 7 of those bowl games. But again, the new staff comes in, and this team has really adapted to it well.
They seem to like Jags around here, that's for sure. Everybody's talking about him. Of course, so when you win, everything's great. Going for the home run ball here. Off the hands of Clarence Megua in the end zone. Antonio Smith, the cornerback, was beaten by about a half a step there, but pass a little long.
It was a real good pass. The wind is blowing that way in the stadium, and he put some real nice air under this, leading the receiver to the boundary and just out of the receiver's reach. I think Megua did a good job running and reaching out for the ball, but perhaps if he had left his feet, he would have had a better chance. But you can't throw a ball any better than that.
That's the first incompletion today for Ryan.
And that was a great throw. I tell you, Steve Logan really believes in the deep ball, works on it, and that was a great throw, I believe.
Caught. And there's Rich Gannell. That's a gain of five. College football on ESPNU continues today as Matt Grothy leads the sixth-ranked South Florida Bulls against the Florida Atlantic Owls. It's coming up at 3:30 Eastern time today on ESPNU. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. I did not stutter. I said the sixth-ranked South Florida Bulls.
They better be ready to play. Howard Snellenberger at Florida Atlantic. He'll have his troops ready. They're a pretty good football team this year.
We're going to be seeing the Bulls next week. Got them at noon. They're taking on Central Florida a week from today. Calendar again. It's piled up.
Decision time now for BC. Probably a little bit out of field goal range.
I'd have to say, if you're Bowling Green, you know what? BC could run anything at this point. They've given it to the back. They've thrown it on a swing pass, the intermediate route out in the flat. They've tried it deep. I mean, if you're a linebacker for Bowling Green, you just got to play it straight up.
We do. I tell you, the thing I like about Ryan, you know, I, former quarterback coach, I used to make your receivers look good. He throws catchable balls. He makes his receivers look good, I believe.
Well, they're going to go for it here on fourth and four. They're perfect this season on fourth down. In fact, 4 for 4, but penalty flags come in to stop this play.
Costanzo, I believe, moved a little bit early, so it's going to be a procedure. BC will probably punt the football now.
Prior to the snap, ball start, offense number 74.
And you're right, Costanzo on that right side. Now, he is starting as a true freshman, one of six offensive linemen from Jagosinski's first recruiting class, but the first true freshman to start on the offensive line in 10 years for BC. They like this kid's upside, but a freshman mistake there, Drew.
That type of thing is definitely going to happen in an atmosphere like this. It's just unfortunate that it happened on fourth down. He's just trying to get a little jump and try to get a little extra and got caught.
Johnny Ayers, the senior out of Oakton, Virginia, to punt for the first time today. Nice kick. Drops it at the 11-yard line. Takes a little bit of a sideways bounce. And they've got Bowling Green back deep at the 10-yard line when we come back. A 31-yard kick for Ayers. The Boston College fans happy about their Eagles are on top 7-3.
If you have diabetes, then you know what this is. It's your lifeline. Luckily for us, these new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Access Diabetic Supply will send you one of these new meters, no charge. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Call Access now to see if you qualify.
Call 800-398-7722.
It's time for the Midnight Madness to begin. Get ready for the tip-off of the basketball season as we take you out to four different schools for your first look at their programs with our exclusive insider analysis. Midnight Madness starts Friday at 7, only on ESPNU. ESPNU is the only place to get analysis like this.
We're starting off this show with amazing news.
Each week, our crew breaks down the top 25.
These are two very evenly matched teams.
Inside the Polls, Mondays at 7 p.m. on ESPNU.
If you've had it with raking leaves every year, let me send you one of our DR Leaf and Lawn Vacuums for use on your property this fall. The DR Leaf and Lawn Vacuum attaches to your riding mower and will vacuum up a yard full of leaves while you ride. Our patented shark tooth impeller shreds leaves to a fraction of their original volume. For smaller properties, DR also offers walk-behind models to clean up large, open areas and all those hard-to-reach spots. You'll be impressed with either machine. But if you decide to return the DR, we'll come pick it up and you won't be out a penny. If you decide to keep it, you'll make no payments and pay no interest for 6 months.
Call today, 1-800-418-1910, for free details about the exciting DR Leaf and Lawn Vacuum, including how you can try one risk-free. So call 1-800-418-1910 or visit drleafvac.com.
DR is professional power for homeowners.
Larry Coker, Gerard Phelan, Clay Matvick back here. Boston College on top 7-3. Seconds to go here before the end of the first quarter. Tyler Sheehan and the Bowling Green offense going back to work from their own 10-yard line. Sheehan. Gives to Jeter, one of the rare runs. Shakes free, now looking for some operating room around the corner. Stood up and run out of bounds by Jamie Silva. There is a penalty flag down after that 5-yard gain.
Jeter lined up in a running back position, but he's not a running back. He's more of a receiving type player, receiving back, and just a rare draw play that Bowling Green will run.
Well, now they're going to find themselves in trouble. They were accused of holding, and they're going to move the ball back to about the 5-yard line. And when you're throwing the ball on every play, you've got to be real careful with the ball down here.
Holding. Offense number 80. After this to the goal. Still first down.
Well, I believe they were more than accused. I believe they were guilty. They got called. They got penalized.
That's Keston Cheatham, number 80, junior receiver. And that's going to make Greg Brandon's hair turn gray if that kind of stuff happens. Like you said, when you're in a passing situation every down, you don't want to be throwing from your own end zone.
Yeah, right there's the hole of the upper left of your screen. See the hands reach out and grab. It's pretty obvious for the official to call.
Sheehan. Chased, pressured, down he goes at the 4-yard line. Demeek Scafay is down. A loss of 3. He was there for the tackle. And he's in some pain inside the 5-yard line.
I think he just fell wrong as he went down. I mean, Demeek is 6'3", 305, a redshirt freshman. He's been chasing this quarterback around all day, and it's been warm.
All right, we've got a quarter in the books. Boston College 7, Bowling Green 3 here at Chestnut Hill. Back for more after this.
ESPNU Coaches Spotlight, Tuesdays at 1, only on ESPNU.
Amazing love, how can it be?
These are the ultimate songs of faith.
Here I am to worship. Here I am to bow down. Here I am to say that.
These are songs of the ultimate love.
Lord, I lift your name on high.
Time Life presents Open the Eyes of My Heart, today's greatest worship anthems.
Open the eyes of my heart.
You'll hear Michael W. Smith, Mercy Me, Chris Rice, Darlene Check, today's biggest Christian artists.
I'm trading my sorrows. I'm trading my
22 songs of power.
Come, now is the time to worship.
22 songs of passion.
God of wonders beyond our galaxy.
Call now to get Open the Eyes of My Heart on 2 CDs for just $19.99.
Word of God speak, would you pour down like rain?
But wait, order with your credit card and we'll take $10 off.
Now I know my Redeemer.
That's 2 CDs for just
$9.99. Hallelujah, grace like rain.
Then preview other inspirational albums. Satisfaction guaranteed. So call now and get Open the Eyes of My Heart on 2 CDs for just $9.99.
Call 1-800-503-7019 to order Open the Eyes of My Heart on 2 CDs for $9.99 plus shipping and handling when you use your credit card. Or order online at timelife.com/open the eyes.
This will be a long game, a lot of passing, huh?
Oh, yeah, wow. That's a long quarter.
Start of the second quarter now, Boston College on top of Bowling Green, 7-3. Well, lace up your skates for college hockey on ESPNU Sunday afternoon as the 7th-ranked Clarkson Golden Knights face neighbor and rival St. Lawrence, the Saints of St. Lawrence. Hockey on ESPNU coming up on Sunday, 4 o'clock Eastern. For more information, go to the web, ESPNU.com. And speaking of hockey, the second winningest coach in college hockey history, Jerry York of the BC Eagles, joins us. Good to see you, Jerry.
Good to see you, Clay.
The second-ranked team in the country here, we understand.
Yeah, we've got North Dakota coming in here October 19th, which should be a fabulous battle and plenty of seats available.
Should be a good year. Always look forward to hockey. From the end zone, scrambling, Sheehan got it away and out of bounds. Well, like you said, the season ready to start. You finished as the national runner-up last year. And what do you have coming back this year?
You know, we return the bulk of our team. We'll be a little untested in goal when Corey Snyder decided to sign with Vancouver over the summer. But I like our club, and I think we'll be a very good team this year.
Larry, I know you are a big-time hockey fan hailing from Oklahoma. But as a coach, you can certainly relate. This guy has done a lot in college hockey. And, you know, I know you're a fan of the game.
Well, I don't know a lot about it. I know this, in Oklahoma City, they have a minor league team. They have a 17, 18,000 seat stadium in Oklahoma City. They fill it up to watch minor league hockey. I know that.
Well, it's a great sport. I think it's catching on in places that are unusual like that.
Of course, you've got some ties to Bowling Green, too, Coach. You won a national championship there in 1984, your first of two. You came over to B.C. You won one here in 2001.
Yeah, you know, I've always had special memories of Bowling Green. They've got a fabulous coach now, Scott Pollock, and pretty soon they're going to be knocking on the door and win another one.
There's some pictures of a younger Jerry York. Do you remember those days?
No gray hair, Larry, huh? Gerard gave me gray hair on the golf course. Taking all my money.
Hey, I'll tell you what, you've been doing a great job down there. That's really the key hockey team in all of New England, Boston College.
I know the Bruins opened up their season last night, but... you know, when you're the number two team in the country and you're playing for national championships as you have been, you're gonna make the front of the sports page quite a bit. And speaking of that 84 team, let's go back to your first national championship. What stands out from that season here at Bowling Green?
You know, just a terrific run. We got red hot to the end, and Gino Cavallini, who had a great career with the St. Louis Blues, scored just a fabulous goal and four overtimes beat Duluth. Here it is. Yeah, Danny Kane had it, dished it off to Gino, and made a great move coming across, and Rick Crosley. That was a fabulous night for us.
Four overtimes at the arena that, of course, the 1980 gold medal team made famous.
Coach, you had a lot of Hobie Baker Award winners here, and now out on the football field, being a football guy, that's all I really know. Don't ask me about
it. I thought you were a hockey guy. Sure.
I like to watch hockey. I don't know anything about it. But Matt Ryan's out here, and a lot of folks are talking about him with the Heisman Trophy. You've coached some of the guys that have won the Hobie Baker. You know, what's that like for a kid at this point?
Well, I think Matt is, I've known him for a long time as he's gone through the progression here from young freshman to a polished senior. He'll handle all the publicity very well. And, you know, SI was in, and of course ESPN's been talking to him, and he's got a great, you know, level head on his shoulder. You know, you could tell me more about him as a football player, but as a young guy, I think he'll handle everything. And, you know, really, he's looking forward to a terrific year here for the Eagles.
Jerry York is joining us here, one of the college hockey coaching legends in this country. And you are second in wins behind just one man, Ron Mason at Michigan State. Of course, Michigan State is the team that you lost to for the national championship last year in St. Louis.
You would have to bring that up.
Well, I'm sorry. I happen to be there, too. And I know Mason was there, too, because he's now the athletic director at Michigan State. What's your relationship with Ron?
Well, he was a very difficult coach to follow. I was at Clarkson University, and I went down to Bowling Green, and he had just left there and really had built an outstanding program. And you know, whenever you follow a coach that's done that, it's very difficult. But he was helpful to me during the stretch. And, of course, then we had to play Michigan State, so wasn't that helpful on the other side. But I talked to him a lot.
Well, here's the flashback. Sorry to do this again, Jerry, but it was such a good hockey game. It was tied at one late in the third quarter. Then Michigan State scored the go-ahead goal and then the empty netter to get the 3-1 win.
You know, and one of the things everybody talks about is the disappointment, but it also builds, you know, a terrific atmosphere in your club. The longer you go into postseason and play big games, you just benefit the next year. It'd be like Larry when his teams went to the big bowl games, the BCS bowl games, that extra practice, the extra preparation. Then you go back the next year, you're much better because of it. So I think it's helped us in a number of ways.
Well, Jerry, we thank you very much for stopping up here today. We look forward to watching your team during the college hockey season. It should be a fun year. Season ready to start here in a week.
Yeah, thank you, Clay. I appreciate that.
Jerry York, the Boston College head coach, joining us here as his team is ranked number two in the country. So Boston College has it second down and two. Ryan giving off to Callender. And Callender, a 3-yard gain. He only needed two, and Boston College has another first down.
Well, we're starting to see some hands on the hips now as the second quarter starts. I think a big key in this football game is going to be with all the running that's going on in the secondary, with all the onus on the defensive front trying to put quarterback on the pressure on these very talented quarterbacks. It's going to be a matter of conditioning when you get to about the midway through the fourth quarter.
And they haven't touched Matt Ryan yet, so it's going to be conditioning, and it hasn't started out well for Bowling Green as far as the pressure on the quarterback.
Ryan on first and 10. Nice catch. Ryan Purvis, the tight end. 15-yard grab, took a smack, but hangs on.
This is really a big time throw because he had under coverage, and Ryan had perfect pass coverage, but was able to wait and be patient until Purvis cleared the under coverage, and then he just threw the ball right in there before the free safety was able to lower the boom. So this is the look from the free safety standpoint, just up over the under coverage. Purvis made a real nice catch and holding on to the football as he gets jarred.
Ryan now 11 of 12 passing. That one was tipped, caught wide open his calendar, and he takes it in easily. Calendar has 5 rushing touchdowns on the year. You can add that one receiving. And now Boston College has opened up a 13-3 lead.
Calendar's been looking for a breakout game, and this is really becoming it for him. He has the first touchdown on a 40-yard run, and now just a little swing pass, and there's not a lot of work to be done right here.
Papadopoulos on for the extra point. Of course, his nickname, Sid Vicious. And BC has a 14-3 lead early on here in the second quarter. So as advertised, Matt Ryan looking good. His Heisman hopes continue to be bolstered. The Eagles on top.
The new game demands today's stars show skills at a whole new level. The new RBK Edge uniform is designed to get them there. Bold, breathable, lightweight. Built for speed and power. Put one on and feel how the game has evolved. The new RBK Edge system, evolution of the hockey uniform. Now playing at Dick's Sporting Goods.
Okay. Hi, I'm Jennifer Love Hewitt. It is time to come right out with it. To talk freely and openly about my love affair with Proactive Solution.
I think people would be surprised to know that I've had little problems here and there because Hollywood's job is to make it seem like everything's effortless for us and we wake up looking this way and then of course we don't have pimples or anything else.
My breakouts were under the skin, all in this sort of area. And that's the difficult stuff to cover. So I decided to try Proactive. And within probably a week and a half, my skin was completely different. And every day there was just less pimples on my face.
Wouldn't you like to watch your pimples just disappear? Now you can with Proactive's proven 3-step system. Proactive combines powerful medicines with soothing botanicals to heal acne and prevent future breakouts.
Once I started using Proactive, it really balanced my skin out. Now I have nice skin, so it's good.
Don't wait any longer to try Proactive, the number one best-selling acne system in America, and save 50%, just $19.95.
What's so great about Proactive is not only did I get rid of the blemishes, but my skin, my actual skin improved.
I love being able to look in the mirror and just go, wow, you know?
And the best part? Proactive guarantees clear skin on all ages and all skin types, or your money back.
With a 60-day money-back guarantee, why not try Proactive? If it doesn't work for you, you just send back the bottles and get a complete refund. There's no reason not to try it, and one big reason you should. Beautiful, clear skin.
Order Proactive in the next 4 minutes and get a special free gift. It's the Amazing Refining Mask, designed to clear problem zits fast. Call 1-800-235-0431. Act quickly and get a free upgrade to priority shipping.
Proactive totally saved my skin. It's my skin again, and it feels great.
We told you it wasn't just Matt Ryan. It's also Andre Callender and other guys. But Andre Callender has done a nice job today. In fact, the rest of the team hasn't done what Callender has done.
Callender had 132 yards earlier in the season. And he's already got 99. We're just getting started here in a second.
One rushing touchdown from 51 yards and one receiving touchdown. Here's Billy Bennett's squib kick. Roger Williams watches it go out of bounds. Worst penalty here on Boston College. Let's go to the studio and Mike Gleason.
Clay, Pat White, West Virginia banged up against South Florida, back in the lineup against Syracuse. Why not? Last year, he ran for 247 and four touchdowns. Here he reaches the end zone for one touchdown, is he?
You know, intended for Ty Smith. Second tip of the day, big nose tack and Keelan Dykes for the touchdown. First defensive touchdown of the year for West Virginia.
21-7, Clay.
Mike and Steve, thank you very much. Syracuse has come back down to earth a little bit after that upset of Louisville. And West Virginia trying to get Steve Slayton back on track a little bit. Looks like things are going well for the Mountaineers right now. First down, 10 to go, 11:28 to go in the half.
Ball kicked out of bounds. There's a penalty, and Bowling Green decided to take the ball on the 35-yard line rather than make BC kick.
Sheehan. A little high, and Corey Partridge went up, tried to catch it. Lands incomplete. College football on ESPNU continues tonight with two games. First at 7 Eastern, Tulane taking on the Black Knights of Army. Then at 10 Eastern, the Maine Black Bears going up against Hofstra. Saturday, primetime college football presented by City on ESPNU. For more information, go to ESPNU.com. So second and 10 now for Sheehan. Nice crossing route. And inside Boston College territory, Marcus Parks. He has become Bowling Green's number three option at wide receiver. We talked about Partridge and Barnes. This guy wears number three, and he is number three.
But he also brings some size down there. 6'2", 228 pounds. He's just a redshirt freshman running wide open in the middle of the field. What a big target.
Very nice. A nice job picking up the blitz by the Bowling Green offensive line and back.
Play selection. Really distorted. Now Sheehan is a little distorted as he goes down. Alex Albright having a great first half. That's the second time he's made the big play. A loss of four.
Well, BC's running in and out of defensive linemen, trying to keep them fresh. And this time Albright does a nice job coming off the block. Sheehan just isn't quick enough to get away.
Yards passing for Sheehan. It's a big play here. Second down, trying to pick up some yardage. Partridge has it, and he's got enough for the first down. Great run after the catch. Shed a couple of tacklers to pick it up.
Well, that's what we were talking about in the pregame, Clay. BC linebacker had him tackle short of the first down. No, I'm sorry, it's a safety man. But again, he breaks the tackle. He goes ahead and makes the first down. That's a great job by the Bowling Green offense. That's what they rely on to move the chains.
So Partridge with a gain of 16 and a first down at the 31-yard line. Sheehan. Got it to Winovich. And Pete Winovich with a good gain. He's got 9 on that play. Winovich is a senior fullback. But again, the tailbacks and the fullbacks really aren't that. Everyone is expected to catch the ball.
Well, I'll tell you, they're doing a good job down there mixing up the defense a little bit. That time we had Kevin Akins, who's a cornerback, sort of milling around there to cover Pete Winovich. So you had the matchup that you wanted, but they were able to get the ball in there.
Here's a little handoff. You don't see this a ton, but Partridge can't take Boston College by surprise. They were trying the little end-around play. It didn't work. Actually, that was Freddie Barnes. And it's going to bring up second down and one. Now check that, third down and one.
Well, they may measure here, Clay, but you have to run a long way and hold blocks a long time for that play to be effective, or there has to be a crease in the defense. Boston College did a great job. There was no crease in the defense.
Maybe he did get it. From up here, it didn't look like it at first, but the officials do want to measure.
That's quite a short yardage offense. Go about 60 yards across the field to pick up one. But it worked.
Hey, got it. Freddie Barnes picking it up, and he's one of those guys that's really athletic. Number 7 for Bowling Green. they just try to find ways to get the ball in his hands.
I really like him. He's a former quarterback, and he understands the passing game a little more maybe than some wide receivers would. He understands a little bit more about protections and about what a quarterback sees and how to get open.
This is a big series here for Bowling Green. They're marching in the red zone now. They're 15 of 16 coming into this game. Complete. Down at the 6-yard line, Corey Partridge, and Bowling Green is banging on the door.
Well, they just seem to be throwing the ball at will right here. Bowling Green's doing a very nice job with the receivers, splitting the seams back in zone defense. And she's just having a day back there. Wonderful pass coverage and a nice strike through it, nice and low, so that Jamie Silva didn't have a chance to make a play on it.
It was a nice window. She hadn't really anticipated that window and made a nice throw in that open area in the zone, against the zone defense.
Sheehan, after that 14-yard completion, throws it behind Parks, and it'll bring up second down.
It's a very rare incompletion right here. I think what happened is at the line of scrimmage, we can't see it from our vantage point high above the field, but from the line of scrimmage, I don't think there was a passing lane to get the ball through to Parks.
Bowling Green needs touchdowns. Field goals are not going to win this football game for Bowling Green. They need touchdowns. Obviously, you've got to score. For Bowling Green to win the game is going to have to score touchdowns in the end zone, not settle for field goals.
This team is averaging over 34 points per game. So, Larry, they are used to doing just that. They need a 6 here. To the end zone. Caught. Touchdown. Freddie Barnes.
That's a great catch. That ball was thrown behind through a window, and he readjusted, turned his body, made a great catch by Freddie Barnes. Again, the former quarterback at Bowling Green.
That's his 4th touchdown catch of the year, this one from 6 yards out. And Bowling Green hanging right in there.
Well, they're executing very well. That was the battle cry coming into this game. Go out, do what we do. Don't let Boston College shake us. We're going to have some plays. We're not going to complete passes. They're going to make some big plays, but just keep doing what we're doing and we'll be okay.
Sinisha Vervillo with the extra point. And Bowling Green Falcons back within 4.
Strengthen and tone, sculpt and define. Now, there's a new way to get fit quick.
Hi, I'm Jack Satorski, and I set the world record for push-ups in 2003. And now, I'm going to show you how to get the ultimate upper body workout quickly and effectively with the Push-Up Pro. It's the new way to sculpt and tone the chest, shoulders, arms, and even abs. And I guarantee you'll see and feel an amazing difference in your body within 10 days. And here's why. Just look at the normal push-up. Look at the strain on the wrists. Now, look at the difference with the Push-Up Pro. It uses a more natural movement for the arms and shoulders. And by adding the rotation, you're now targeting 2 movements of the chest and getting a more powerful contraction of the muscle. Beginners, use Push-Up Pro on a wall for an easy yet effective workout. As you progress, move to the floor in this modified position, and when you're ready, shred up with the advanced move. Then step it up to expert level. Whether you're 8 or 80, you can strengthen and tone with the Push-Up Pro. It's the ultimate upper body workout.
It rotates your arm, so it feels like it's hitting more of the shoulder. You get better results, you're working more muscle.
I didn't feel any pain in my wrists at all. It felt like a very natural movement from the top position, lowering myself to the floor.
It's great to be in your 50s and find something so simple. I do it right against the wall. It's really easy and convenient. It's perfect.
With the Push-Up Pro, you'll shape, define, and tone in all the right places. In fact, we guarantee you'll see results within 10 days or your money back. And best of all, you can take your workout with you. Call now and get your hands on the Push-Up Pro for only $19.99. And I'll also send you my training guide, the ultimate upper body workout. Call now.
Call now to order Push-Up Pro for the amazing price of only $19.99 plus shipping and handling. It's never been easier to strengthen, sculpt, and define with the ultimate upper body workout. Call 1-800-631-2758. That's 1-800-631-2758. Call now.
Join our crew as they break down the latest Top 25. Inside the Polls, Mondays at 7 p.m. on ESPNU.
Georgia Tech fresh off of their win over Clemson last week, keeping a Davis and Spiller out of the end zone. Not against Maryland. Lance Ball, fifth touchdown, fourth in three games, 14-3. Maryland on top.
Yeah, Bush Davis has this program going in the right direction. And T.J. Yates with the keeper right there, starting QB, is the reason why.
20-0 Carolina, Clay.
All right, guys, thank you very much. Georgia Tech is that team that Matt Ryan shredded for over 400 yards of passing earlier this season. Really made everybody in the country take notice of this BC team. Jeff Smith back in his own end zone, coming out. Out at the 20 to the 25, still on his feet. Finding room on that far sideline, and there Jeff Smith goes. Inside Bowling Green territory to the 35-yard line. And remember, he was still out last week with that concussion. This is his first game back.
Boston College is glad to have him back, too, because this is the kind of explosive athlete that he is.
Jeff Smith does a great job here. Watch a little hesitation move to let things set up right here and now, outside there, right there. Now, watch him accelerate. That's a great job by Jeff Smith to set it up. Great blocking by the BC return team, and what a great play for BC. That's what they needed, and again, just countering back from what the Bowling Green has just scored with a touchdown. Now BC's coming back with a vengeance.
It's a nine-play touchdown drive for Bowling Green, and Jeff Smith answers back with a 64-yard kickoff return from out of his own end zone. All right, here's Ryan out of the gun. Throws it out, has Callender, and he's down at the 33, a four-yard pickup. Let's bring in a good friend of Gerard's. Doug Flutie's in the ABC studios today. And Doug, what do you think of this BC team? This is their highest rank since 1984 when you were still the big man on campus.
They're just very efficient. I love watching Matt Ryan play a quarterback. He's smart with the football, not afraid to let it fly down the field. They're just a good, solid, all-around team.
Doug, this is Larry Coker. I called it surgery before. He just makes the receivers look so good. He's relaxed. He throws everything catchable. He's very, very impressive.
There's Callender inside the 25, and they'll move the chains again.
Hey, Doug, we were talking yesterday to Ryan about, you know, he's starting to get a lot of play about being All-American and the run for the Heisman and that sort of thing. And you've spent a lot of time, have some good exposure nationally to other quarterbacks that are out there. How do you think he stacks up?
He's in the top two or three quarterbacks in the country, in my mind, no doubt about it. The way he's just today, standing in the pocket, surveying the field, being relaxed in the pocket, throwing a football, he stacks up very well with anyone.
Here's Ryan. Oh, that pass probably should have been caught, maybe a little bit behind Brandon Robinson. It'll land incomplete.
Doug, how's it different now? Obviously, you won the Heisman Trophy. Is the hype the same then or the same now as it was then? It seems like now you're so scrutinized every moment of the day almost.
Well, the thing that amazes me about it now is the PR that goes into it even before a year starts. I mean, the Big East was running commercials for their guys that had a shot.
Right.
It's just a different ballgame now where it's so publicized and pushed by the athletic department.
Here's Ryan again on second down at 10. Has plenty of time. It's going to be short of the first down. Down at the 15, the 8-yard gain there by Jarvis. Now, of course, this is the play that connects you and Gerard forever. 6 seconds to go against Miami in 84.
I'm still waiting for Gerard to drop this thing. He's got one more chance here.
Hey, so's Miami. They're waiting for him to drop it also.
That's the beauty of film.
What was that play call?
I'm sorry?
What was that play call?
55 flood tip was the play call. And the idea is throw it into the bunch, the biggest guy go up and tip it up in the air and somebody come down with it. Gerard just figured he'd catch it.
Callender inside the 10-yard line as we're talking with Doug Flutie, the 1984 Heisman Trophy winner. He's in the ABC studios today, taking some time out of his day to join us here as your good buddy Gerard is going to be going into the Hall of Fame here at BC today. And your thoughts on Gerard?
It's about time. I mean, the guy, I don't know how many balls I threw that weren't intended for Gerard that Gerard came up with. I mean, big third down conversions cost of that game against Miami.
He caught 11 balls in that Miami game, Doug.
Yeah, he caught 11, and he had two of them were routes where he's running an in route, and he felt the defensive back overplay him. He put his foot in the ground, ran back to the corner, and we had big third down conversions on him.
You were getting it to me all the time, buddy. So, you know, it was always on me to get open. I knew the ball would show up.
Now, of course, Doug is going into the College Football Hall of Fame in December.
Yeah, he is. And congratulations, Doug. Well deserved. It's, you know, one of many accolades that, you know, you've earned in all of your career, both at Boston College in Canada and certainly in the NFL. And it's really fun to have been a part of the early part of it and to watch you do what you do.
You know, looking back at it all now, we had a lot of players on that team, and it was such a, I mean, we ran the ball well, too. We had three running backs go into the NFL. We had offensive linemen, linebackers. Billy Romanowski was on that team, Mike Ruth. I mean, we had a great football team. It just allowed us to get a little attention.
Ryan wants to throw to the end zone, has a receiver. It is down, incomplete. Justin Jarvis, who's 6'5", not tall enough to go get that one for Matt Ryan, but they'll get another crack at it coming up here.
This is just a great play by a level-headed quarterback right here. He really didn't have anything. Bowling Green did a fine job covering in the end zone, and he just went high to Jarvis in hopes that he might be able to catch the ball, make a play, but put it in a place where it wasn't going to get picked.
You know, I hate to make comparisons, guys, but, you know, Gerard, are there any comparisons between Ryan and Doug?
But, you know, they're just two different style quarterbacks. You know, Doug could throw the heck out of the ball. And, you know, Ryan's got a big league arm as well. I think those are the two biggest comparisons.
There's a touchdown on the ground. Andre Callender, his second rushing touchdown today, his third overall. And, Doug, this team, you know, answers right back after Bowling Green went down and scored.
No doubt about it. And part of that, the big part, was Jeff Smith's kickoff return. Jeff just rejoining the team. It's great to see him back with the guys and for him to be a big impact on that. That's how you answer. I mean, they right away, they cut it back down to a one-score game. BC answers the score, marches it right back down, made it look easy.
Well, now this play appears to be under review. Maybe he did not get in. Perhaps the knee was down. Here's another look.
Here's a look at it from the goal line. We'll see. Let's see if the ball goes over the goal line before his knee touches. It's really hard to see. That looks like a touchdown to me.
Hey, guys, my buddy John Saunders says they ought to make it look easy. They're playing Bowling Green, for crying out loud.
Yeah, he's not here, though. He's not here, believe me.
I know.
You get that man some film, he'll see what they're all about.
Know. Exactly. You know, especially teams that can spread the field out and have a quarterback pulling the trigger that knows what he's doing.
Confirmed. Touchdown.
Now the play stands, Doug. It's a touchdown.
It's a great equalizer when you can spread the field out and throw the football. You know, you can move the ball on anyone. Size, strength, you know, whether you're a Big Ten team or an SEC team, whatever it is, you can compete with them.
Doug, at Miami, I had NFL linebackers because of spread offenses that maybe sit on the bench for most of the game because defensive backs were in. You couldn't match up. So it can be real frustrating.
Yeah, you wind up with all kinds of personnel groupings.
Exactly.
Hey, Doug, good luck down there. You're doing a great job on the studio and the games and such. It's nice to see you transition as well into you know, the broadcasting field.
Thanks a lot, Gerard. You guys take it easy.
Appreciate it.
All right, Doug, congratulations on your honor going into the College Football Hall of Fame in December, spending some time with us today. He's going to be in the ABC studios with John Saunders and company. So Boston College going right back down the field. It's now 21-10 with 6 minutes to go here in the first half.
Hey, I'm a pretty old guy, but I remember Doug Flutie with a drop kick for the New England Patriots versus the Miami Dolphins. The only drop kick I've ever seen in football. I saw it then.
Yeah, that thing went out with the, you know, the buggy whip.
I don't know, man.
I haven't seen that. I don't think I've ever seen it. Here's one more look. This is the last time that Boston College has beaten Miami.
Yeah, we really fought very, very hard. The entire team, offense and defense, for this game, and it was on national television. And, you know, everybody was so bummed out. It looked like we were going to lose the game. And, you know, the offense went out with some purpose in their eyes. And, you know, this play doesn't work a whole lot, but every now and then it does work, and it's sensational.
Well, many thought that that play clinched the Heisman Trophy for Doug Flutie, but actually the voting was done before that game ever took place. It was the day after Thanksgiving.
Well,
what a whip.
That's indicative of everything that Doug does. He just, with that play in that game, he just put an exclamation on it.
Kick is short, taken by one of the up men down at the 40-yard line. That's where Bowling Green will start.
You like to see a Heisman Trophy winner like Doug Flutie because he earned it. I don't think any hype or publicity got him the trophy. He got the trophy by his play on the field. I had a player at Oklahoma State, Barry Sanders. Nobody knew who he was going into the season. His play on the field got him the trophy, and that's what happened, I believe, with Doug Flutie here at Boston College.
Well, and that's what all of the recruiting coordinators around the country, I'm sure you see it every day, Coach, they want guys that make plays.
Bowling Green at their own 40. Pretty good field position here. See what they can do for to answer back here out to the 44. That's Partridge. Let's go to the studio and Mike Gleason.
And Clay, some shocking news from Chapel Hill is.
Yeah, look at the end around by receiver Brandon Tate. Look at, no one's there. Now watch a great downfield block coming up. Just right there, frees him up, the stutter move, takes him for the touchdown.
27-0, North Carolina. Mike Hart just became the all-time leading rusher, passing the A-train, Anthony Thompson. Michigan 16-5 over Eastern Michigan. Clay.
Mike, Steve, thank you very much. Sheehan pressured, throws, picked off. Intercepted by Jamie Silva, still on his feet, and he could go all the way. 65-yard interception return for a touchdown. Boston College coming into the day, fifth in the country with 10 interceptions, make it 11.
Well, talking to Coach Spaziani, he was hoping that something like this was going to happen, and Jamie Silver playing free safety out there in the middle of the field. Sheehan just made a mistake. The ball came out a little high. He had some pressure late, and Silver was there to pick it off, his third interception of the year. What a run.
You like to see that. That really ignites the offense, and it emphasizes team.
Apanavicius, another PAT, and that is the third interception this season for Silva, having an outstanding senior year. Big play there puts Boston College on top, 28-10.
Maybe your car is trying to tell you something. Maybe it's asking for the hard-working gasoline at Phillips 66, gas specially formulated to help clean fuel injectors in 5 tanks, which helps you maximize mileage and reduce emissions. Give your car what it's asking for. Give it Phillips 66. Hard-working gas.
It's time for the Midnight Madness to begin. Get ready for the tip-off of the basketball season as we take you out to 4 different schools for your first look at their programs with our exclusive insider analysis. Midnight Madness starts Friday at 7, only on ESPNU.
ESPNU Coaches Spotlight gets you the inside scoop on the top college football teams. Catch all the press conferences and find out the campus lowdown live from our panel of experts. ESPNU Coaches Spotlight, Tuesdays at 1, only on ESPNU.
As we grow older, one of the greatest challenges we face is being able to hold on to our independence while still being able to get assistance when we need it. Hello, I'm Lee Merriweather, and if you live alone, I urge you to look into the Alert USA Personal Emergency Response System. With this system, if you ever fall or otherwise require assistance, simply press the button on your pendant and you'll be connected to an operator at our monitoring station who can summon help 24 hours a day. And while you may have seen similar products advertised on television before, Alert USA is one of the most advanced systems on the market today, yet it's very affordable. So remain independent while remaining safe with Alert USA. To find out more, call today for a free brochure.
For a free brochure, call 1-800-652-0101. For a limited time, get the Alert USA system for just 50 cents a day. Call now, 1-800-652-0101.
There's Quincy Market, one of the historic spots here in Boston. Boy, this town is just full of history.
Oh.
And this Boston College team making a little sports history perhaps this season. Number 7 team in the country on top, 28-10.
And you just feel the momentum swinging to Boston College's side right now. But Bowling Green is going to have to be patient moving forward. Coach, what would you say to Sheehan when he goes on the field?
I'd say just relax. Let's stay with the game plan. Don't force it. Take what they give you. I know that's coach talk, but I think that's a good approach. And I think if they do that, they still have got a good game plan. They're moving the football, making first downs. I think they'll be fine, but they just have to not panic.
Roger Williams on that return, 22 yards. And let's see what Tyler Sheehan can do now. That interception, the fifth he's thrown here this year.
Well, this is the sort of thing that goes to the character and the leadership side of being a great quarterback. I saw Sheehan down on the field after BC had scored. He's walking around, you know, talking to his players, trying to get them ready to go. This game's by far over, and they just need to go out and execute.
That's complete. And it's going to be enough for the first down for Corey Partridge, and that's how they do things. They can just keep that rhythm up, get back in this thing in a hurry.
Well, I think the BC defense can't relax. They've got to keep the pressure on and realize this team from Bowling Green can score a lot, and they can score in a hurry. They've got to keep the foot on the accelerator, so to speak.
Doubt this Bowling Green team has exceeded some expectations this year with the win over Minnesota. Out to the good start at 3-1. And now they're in BC territory at the 49. All right, let's go to the studio and Mike.
Well, Clay, coming up on the Sports Center Halftime Report, this is Gut Check Saturday, so we'll preview the Gators' trip into Baton Rouge to take on the LSU Tigers, and we'll preview or take a look at all the highlights from the ACC. A shocker in Chapel Hill. Coach Coker's former Canes on the short end of that one, and an all-time leading new guy at Michigan rushing the football. Coming up at halftime.
All right, Mike, we look forward to it. I like that. Gut Check Saturday. Here's another one tipped and picked off. Intercepted by the strong safety, Paul Anderson. Back-to-back series where this BC defense has stopped things with a pick.
Well, I said this was a nightmare for a defensive coordinator, but this has become a nightmare for the Bowling Green offense. Again, a high throw, and it's a great job by Frank Spaziani getting coverage. He's mixing that coverage and pressure and really, I think, confusing the Bowling Green offense a little bit.
A real nice spy technique from the nose guard there, stepping out on the back. There was a little bit of pressure up on Sheehan at the same time. Everything happened so fast. You know, the ball comes out, it gets tipped, and all of a sudden you got a disaster on your hands.
So now Ryan under center on first down. Swings it out. And that's going to be a 9-yard pickup for A.J. Brooks, the first time that the running back has touched the ball here today for the Eagles. Now, you guys were talking about Coach Spaz, as he's referred to around here, Frank Spaziani, now in his 9th year. This is 11 seasons now on that BC coaching staff. And along with the linebacking coach, Bill McGovern, he is one of only two coaches that stayed on when Jags took the job.
Well, his family really liked this area, and Jags did as well. He felt very good about all the players that were coming back for Boston College. They have 17 seniors that have graduated, and really bought into Coach Jags' philosophy and decided to stay. And you know, everybody here in the BC community is just delighted.
Last carry by L.V. Whitworth for Boston College. Excuse me.
That was a great job by the BC defense, and. You know, sometimes you keep a coach, a veteran coach. I think that was smart on Coach Jag's part to keep Coach Spaziani.
Ryan throws it out. It's complete to Ryan Purvis inside the 30-yard line, down at the 29. And Jacob Hardwin, defensive end, was back there to make the tackle. It's a 10-yard gain. They'll move the chains here for the Eagles. And Ryan continues to be very precision-like with his passes.
I'm very impressed with Boston College, because a game like this that people, you hear, it's not a game, not a contest, it's just Bowling Green, which isn't the case, but the Boston College is very focused, they're executing, they're playing a very good football game today.
Now, unlike the BC defense, the offense does have a new coordinator, Steve Logan. And there's an incompletion, a rare one so far today for Ryan. Steve Logan was in NFL Europe last year, but when Jagosinski got the job, he came back to work with his old friend. Jagosinski was Logan's assistant at East Carolina in the mid-90s. And they installed the West Coast offense here. And that's an offense, Gerard, that you really need a smart quarterback to run it, because it's a tough offense to learn.
Yeah, I think every coach tries to take their talent and wrap their game plan around the talent. And it's wonderful that Steve Logan has that ability to institute that type of offense for Matt Ryan, who can more than handle it.
A slam, caught and dropped. Jarvis had it momentarily. Came out of his hands.
Incident. as we were talking the other day with Jags and Coach Logan, you could clearly see that there was a good camaraderie between the two of them. And, you know, they spend so much time together on a day-to-day basis. The season is so long. So many good things happen, bad things happen. You got families and all that sort of thing. That chemistry really makes a difference, wouldn't you say, Coach?
No doubt about it. And I tell you, Steve Logan, he's got Matt Ryan in the sandbox. There's some flexibility there. He doesn't let him out of the sandbox out in the street. He's got him in the sandbox, and he's got flexibility. And
that's a good cut there. Jarvis again. And he was wide open. I mean, there was nobody around him within probably 5 yards.
Well, this is just a classic case of the receiver trying to run without the football. You've got to make sure that you secure it when you're running this type of pass control offense. And that ball's right in there.
Heck, 10 yards.
He could feel the end zone as that ball arrived.
Jarvis has one touchdown catch this year. That could have been number two, but they're going to have to settle for a field goal attempt. This is a 45-yard attempt. Papanovicius has a career long of 37, so this would be a new career long if he could bang it home. On the way, long enough, and it's good. Chalk one up for Sid Vicious from way downtown. 45 yards.
Well, this ball is into the wind as well. There's a bit of a breeze on the field, and looking at the telltales on the goalpost, he just kicked it right into the dead of the wind and right down the middle. This, you know, after the drop, you know, to come out and get some points, you know, really helps your offense. You're not there working on a hot day, and to walk away from that drive with points after it had ended so terribly is a good step for Boston College.
Boston College has been really complete. Special teams, a great kickoff return. Now the field goal. Offense, defense creating turnovers. They've been a complete team this first half, and obviously it shows on the scoreboard, 31-10 Eagles.
So a new career long for Steve Papanovicius. For up-to-the-minute news from everything in college sports, log on to ESPNU.com. It's an online service that's a gateway to the best in college sports content from ESPN. If you don't have ESPNU, be sure to log on to ESPNU.com, type in your zip code at the top of the page, call your local cable operator or satellite provider. ESPNU.com, log on today. So they get some points out of that drive. 7 plays, go just 24 yards, but then the big 45-yarder from their field goal kicker.
Boston College has been squib kicking the football to not get a return. Let's see if they continue that philosophy ahead 31-10.
Kind of a wobbly low kick. Williams able to handle it cleanly this time. Penalty flag thrown in. Out to the 40-yard line is Roger Williams. That's a 23-yard return, but there is laundry on the field.
Normally that's in a position where you're going to get a block in the back, and really it's going to put, Bowling Green back really in a hole. Again, Bowling Green can't panic. They're on the road. They're behind, but they've just got to play. They got to play this series. They got to play one play at a time and just make those plays when they have opportunity to.
Here's a look at the storylines from today. Matt Ryan, very good throwing the football. And a lot of times, he's thrown it to his backfield. Andre Callender with that big 51-yard play. Here's Callender again. And then Sheehan with back-to-back interceptions on the last two Bowling Green drives.
Well, they're banging Sheehan around a little bit and disrupting his motion and rhythm. And, you know, that's what you need to do with a young quarterback, because he's going to make a few mistakes. You can see he tried to just lay it in there with a little bit of a touch, and there were just too many bodies in there to throw the ball like that. It's going to get picked.
I agree, Gerard. I think he's out of rhythm a little bit. Boston College has done a better job putting pressure on Sheehan than BG is putting on pressure on Matt Ryan.
Only Jeter, short game there on first down.
I'm sure Bowling Green would be looking for some good production out of Jeter. He's the senior and a guy that can do a lot of things for you. He can run it out of backfield. He can do the sweep for you, catch the ball and turn it upfield and make a good break. He's got the best moves, I think, of the entire skill set for Bowling Green. So, you know, here they are. The team needs some big plays. He's got to step up.
On second and 8, backing into his end zone. That's picked off, and that's a touchdown. Nick Larkin, the senior defensive end, got a gift.
Mark is just back healthy, too. He's been out. He's missed some time. He's back, and he's got to be thrilled about that. A defensive player scoring an offensive touchdown, that's pretty special.
Well, you saw the drop a little bit earlier, and now you see a defensive lineman coming up with a big play. Holy cow. Now, that's a catch.
Really was a nice catch. I actually tipped it one hand and was able to make the catch. And he probably grew up playing a little ball in the backyard.
Most of these guys are, you know, their best athletes on their high school team. So I'll bet he caught a few passes not too long ago.
No doubt about it.
6-yard return for Larkin. And there's a guy who was dressed last week but did not practice. And Coach Jagosinski has a policy that if you don't practice, you don't play. So he had to sit out that Army game. He was just chomping at the bit. Was able to practice this past week, got in, and makes a big play there. It's now 38-10.
And the screen set up, but really defensed well by Boston College.
Here's his reaction coming off the field.
Well, you know, he's to act like he's been there before, but he probably never has, so he probably doesn't know how to act. But that's a great reaction. A lot of enthusiasm, a lot of excitement.
Ron Brace apparently tipped the ball and got it to Larkin, and Larkin gathered it in and took it in from 6 yards out.
One of the great things about college football is just the remarkable enthusiasm. You know, there's a lot of yellow and gold out there, and then you have this big play against this team that's really very talented. Things aren't going well for Bowling Green right now, but, you know, Boston College is out here to try and win the game. You know, they have a good position right now, but they're still having fun down there playing some football.
Let's keep in mind, too, Bowling Green undefeated in the MAC, 1-0. And they expect to be in the thick of it in the MAC East race, and even if they don't get a win on the road at number 7 Boston College, they want to take some positives out of this day and apply that to the rest of their season.
They knew they'd have to have a perfect game to have a chance to win this football game, and again, it just hasn't gone their way, and a lot of credit that goes to Boston College.
Williams, it's a nice little move, gets it out over the 25 to the 27-yard line. 25-yard return for Williams. We're at Alumni Stadium, Chestnut Hill, Massachusetts. He's Larry Coker. He's Gerard Phelan. And I'm Clay Matvick. And we've got a 38-10 game. So look at the total yards, 240 to 179. Bowling Green has thrown 3 straight interceptions on their last 3 drives. This is a big drive here for confidence. And I guess I'm not surprised that they've ran the football on first down. We have seen nothing but passing from this offense so far today, but I think to play it safe, they give it to Bullock.
Well, I think the heat's kind of taking its effect on Bowling Green's offensive line a little bit. I think also they've got all their timeouts left in a little less than 2 minutes. It'll be interesting to see if they try to finish this off and maybe get some points on the board before halftime. That'd be a huge lift for Bowling Green.
Bullock has seen a lot of his carries drop here in the course of the season so far, because Jeter's just a better back for this type of offense. But they've gone to him here on 2 straight plays. It'll bring up 3rd down and about 2 yards to go.
You might see Boston College use a timeout here if Bowling Green does not make the first down. They have all their timeouts left.
Another empty backfield. 5 receivers go downfield. Coming short to Corey Partridge. It is complete, a 4-yard reception for Partridge. And a Bowling Green first down. The clock stops to move the chains with 55 seconds to go here in the half.
Well, that's a big first down for Bowling Green. They needed something positive, and again, they're a long way from a score. Let's see how they try to finish this half. 50 seconds to go. They still have timeouts left.
Sheehan has plenty of time. Deep downfield, it is picked off again. Jamie Silva with the 4th straight Boston College interception, and the 2nd today for Silva.
Well, again, it was an interception, obviously. I think the thing I'd like to see Freddie Barnes compete for the ball a little bit more. You've got to help your quarterback out. He's laid the ball up, trying to give you a chance to make a play. Yeah, go compete for the football and hopefully at least knock it down.
That is the fourth interception of the season for Silva, which now leads the team. Boston, what a day for him.
Boston College is one of the top intercepting teams in the ACC this year, and you can see they're going to help their stats this week.
Yeah, that's 14 now on the year for BC. So Ryan gets the ball back with a little time on the clock, 40 seconds to go. They hand off to Callender. He picks his way across the 25-yard line to the 26. The clock continues to move, a 6-yard gain for Andre Callender. 30 seconds to go here, Coach. What does BC try to do?
I think just run the clock out. Your head 31 to 10. Don't make a mistake to give Bowling Green anything easy. If Matt Ryan just took a knee, that'd be fine. They're not going to run another play. They're going to let the clock run out.
All right, Jeff Jagosinski has to be pleased.
He has to be very pleased. And I tell you, Frank Speziani's got to be pleased. You know, to have the turnovers and points off turnovers, great job by the BC defense.
BC 38, Bowling Green 10. We go to the studio now for an update. Mike is in Charlotte.
All right, thank you, Clay. We'll start in the ACC, or stay there, I guess we say. Maryland, Georgia Tech, both coming up victories, both still fighting for their lives. First quarter, Chris Turner finds Jason Good. Jason Good doesn't catch a lot of balls, or usually doesn't cover this kind of distance.
You know, I'm surprised he was that wide open against a great Georgia Tech defense that hasn't played great all year.
Looked like he was going to run out of gas, 7-0. Rick Costa, Carlos Feliciano collide here. Costa motionless on the field. The stretcher comes out of the field. He's taken for observation. They said when he arrived at the hospital, he did have movement. So that's great news. Lance Ball, 8 yards out, fifth touchdown, fourth in the last three games.
No, Lance Ball is doing a good job. Also with Lattimore giving him the 1-2 punch in that backfield for Maryland Terrapins.
Lattimore just 21 yards. He had another 100-yard game last week, his fourth this year, which leads the ACC. But most importantly, 21-3, Maryland on top of the Yellow Jackets of Georgia Tech. Hi, everybody, and welcome to our SportsCenter U Halftime Report. Steve Israel, Mike Gleason, and this is Gut Check Saturday. And talking about our game, Boston College, 38 points, moving in on their best start since 1954. And a lot of people don't realize Bowling Green, they're averaging about 35 points a game. So I guess BC showing a lot of intestinal fortitude during this Gut Check Saturday.
And what I really like about them most, Mike, they're playing on both sides of the ball. Consistent football, very solid team, BC. And it starts with North Carolina.
Starts with that defense, right?
Exactly. Do you see Jamie Silva doing a great job on defense? He gets an interception here. He's going to return it for a touchdown. They've been playing very, very well across the board. Also, their defensive lineman, Nick Larkin, in the right place at the right time. I mean, they're just doing a great job defensively. Everyone knows about Matt Ryan and the consistency he's been playing with across the board with triple and the great job they've been doing. But it's been the complete team concept. Nick Larkin, as you see there with the tip and a touchdown. When you're able to score points on defense, it makes the world of a difference.
Well, 38 points for BC already, the highest output that matches the highest output for the Eagles of Boston College. You saw a glimpse of North Carolina tape. Well, this is Gut Check Saturday. I guess we couldn't wait to show you what's going on here with Butch Davis against his old team. This is almost unbelievable. Anthony Elzey gets things rolling here with a 40-yard scamper for a touchdown. It's Carolina up 7-0 early on the Canes.
Unbelievable with Miami playing up versus Texas A&M. Now they're playing down. They have to find a way to stay motivated.
Quan Sturtevant with the block. That leads to another touchdown, 20-0. And then Coach Davis says, hey, come on, let's get one more, guys.
That's Brandon Tate on the end around. Great block, and you see no one there. But it doesn't stop there. Didn't you see Akeem Nicks downfield with a good block there on the DB? Tate's in for the touchdown.
You know what? Miami had allowed just one rushing touchdown all season coming into the ball game. So far, three rushing touchdowns for Carolina, 143 yards on the ground, 27-0. And as far as Gut Check Saturday, Miami comes in at 4-1. You see them get blown out by Oklahoma. They're really impressive against Texas A&M. So-so against Duke and Florida International. I guess as far as Gut Check, I guess Carolina wanted this one more.
You know, and it's surprising, too, because if you look at the job that Randy Shannon has done, he's really had this team prepare. But at times, they come out and they look like they're so flat. And it's really following the pace of their quarterbacks. 1 minute, it's going to be Kyle Wright. The next minute, their other quarterback is starting. But Wright is up and down, and the rest of the team is following him.
You know, as you can pick your conference all over the country, there are gut checks. But once again, the brightest marquee shining in the SEC. Number one LSU under the lights with some hungry Gators slithering into Baton Rouge. Plus, we'll check out the Auburn Tigers against Vandy. That's coming up.
Ideas, different people, other cultures. You discover yourself, outgrow old definitions, because learning is expansion of your options, potential, worldview. That's the real value of a university education. That's the BGSU difference. Be part of it. BG and you, changing the world by degrees.
Attention. Diabetic patients with Medicare.
I have diabetes, and testing my blood sugar on my fingers every day is so painful. I wish there were a better way.
Now there is. With this meter, you can test on your arm with less pain. Hello, I'm Dr. Michael Minch, and I've been taking care of diabetic patients for over 30 years. With this new meter, you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. You can test on your arm. It hurts less. Some patients say it doesn't hurt at all.
I called and got my meter. Now my fingers don't hurt anymore.
The club will send your diabetes supplies right to your home, and we will bill Medicare. Membership is free, and so is shipping. So call us now.
Call now to get your meter and test with less pain. Call Diabetes Care Club at 1-800-396-3535. That's 1-800-396-3535.
Call now. I'm glad I did.
If you haven't noticed, Vandy's off to a 3-1 start at Auburn today, but it's the Tigers, Ben Tate, finding the end zone, and the Tigers with the 7-0 lead fresh off of their victory over the Florida Gators. Brandon Cox to Tate again. This one goes 44 yards for the touchdown. Or it leads to the touchdown, I should say. And the Tigers starting to roll now, getting in the fifth gear. Second quarter, 14-0. Mario Fannin, 22 yards, another touchdown, and Auburn now. Well, doing quite well in there. A Saturday gut check leading 21-0 over Vanderbilt. And again, keep in mind, Vandy was 3-1 coming in. And you look at some of the numbers. Earl Bennett opened the day just 11 catches shy of becoming the SEC all-time leader in receptions. But apparently they've taken care of him and shut him down this afternoon. Florida Gators head for Baton Rouge tonight, and safety Tony Joyner will be among them. Joyner had been arrested on a felony charge around 5 o'clock Tuesday morning for attempting to remove his girlfriend's car from a towing company's impound lot. The state attorney's office says the charge was dropped because the owner of the company believes the entire thing was a big misunderstanding. Urban Meyer said the fact Joyner was out that late isn't consistent with the expectations of a leader and a team captain, so Joyner has been stripped of his captaincy. But is he? I don't think it's been determined, or at least it hasn't been announced, if he'll start, but he will play. What does that mean for Florida, making sure that Joyner is in the secondary?
Oh, it means a lot. And the main area it really is going to help is the secondary, where he's at. That secondary across the board, and also an entire defense, is a very young defense, which everyone knows, and it showed versus Auburn. Tony Joyner is the leader of that defense, along with Derek Harvey. They're the only two seniors on that defense. The rest of the guys are sophomores and freshmen, and that leadership is much needed. They had a tough game versus Auburn, but with him back, regardless of if he's the captain or not, it means a lot to that defense.
What about this LSU defense? Tebow is the leading rusher for Florida. I'm not sure if he wants to carry it 26 times tonight, does he?
I tell you what, when I played for the 49ers, we were the number one ranked defense in 1995. The defensive coordinator was Pete Carroll. But you know who else was on that staff?
a defensive quality control guy by the name of Bo Pelini, and it starts in the middle. They love starting the defense, the core being a defensive tackle, and Glenn Dorsey is the heart and soul of this defense.
Well, this one reads that Florida offense against LSU's defense, but with Auburn got done, what they got done last week is one would think LSU should be okay at home under the lights.
Yeah, and they play extremely well, but one thing that you really have to look at is they're very strong at all three levels, starting up front with Dorsey and Tyson Jackson, then Ollie Highsmith, sideline to sideline at the linebacker position, and then with the shutdown corners. A lot of people talk about Glenn Dorsey, but those corners really help him out because of the pressure on the outside that they apply. Look for a lot of pressure to be applied on Percy Harvin.
South Florida cracks the top 10 for the first time ever. Again, defense, the name of the game with the Bulls, but they're taking on a Florida Atlantic team that really knows how to take the football away. 18 takeaways.
And you're right, and it starts with Tavius Polo. You know, they have him listed at 146 pounds. That can't be right. But you know what? As fast as he is and the knack that he has for the football, he's definitely light on his feet, but he's quick with his head and making great moves against the receiver. He's always got his eye on the ball. Whenever you have a DB that can find a ball like that, you have an added bonus for your defense.
How about Ben Moffitt? Almost had three picks against West Virginia.
You know, Ben Moffitt is the prototype middle linebacker. He's gutsy, he's scrappy, he's strong. He led the team last year in tackles. He's on the same pace along with George Selby. Rushing the passer, Mike Jenkins, the DB, they have a strong defense.
Yeah, Selby, 9.5 sacks already. The Bulls have come a long, long way since laying the foundation of that program. Looking from just 2000 to 2007, moving from 1AA to 1A, or football championship subdivision to Bulls subdivision, now to a first top 10 ranking coming in at number 6 this week. Coming up, we move to the Big Ten. Illinois knocked out Penn State. Izzy's upset special last week. Now they have 5-0 Wisconsin, who, despite their record, they've been an enigma themselves. Highlights coming up.
You have to be here.
Attention football fans. Gear up for the season like never before with this NFL Performer Jacket with the logo of your favorite team free. Plus, this NFL collectible football free. That's right. Get this Team Choice NFL Jacket free when you order 56 issues of Sports Illustrated at only $1.59 each. Save 65% off the cover price. Use your credit card and get this NFL football also free. As a special bonus, order at SIOffer.com and get this SI Gym Bag also free. With SI, you'll get the sharpest NFL insights and analysis, spectacular photos, and coverage of all your favorite sports. The SI Fantasy Football section, the must-have preview issues, and the sizzling hot swimsuit issue. And this Team Choice NFL Performer Jacket, free. Use your credit card and get this NFL football also free. And if you order at SIOffer.com, get this SI Gym Bag also free.
Call 1-800-234-9400 now. Call 1-800-234-9400 or visit SIOffer.com.
Well, Mark Mangino's Kansas Jayhawks have been burning out the bulbs on the scoreboard. Defensively, that's where they're ranked number one in the Big 12 in scoring defense and total defense. Do they come down to reality today, though, Kansas State?
Well, it's going to be tough. You know, they have a big-time cornerback, Aheed Tillie, doing a great job. But you know what? On this play right here, he showed me a little bit of quit. There, if you're the top DB in the country, you have to finish that. I see poor effort on that play.
That's Jordy Nelson, 68 yards. He had 12 catches against Texas. Jake Sharp. Now, they haven't scored an offensive touchdown in Manhattan since 1999. That ties the game, so that's huge for Kansas. But Leon Patton comes right back for K-State.
Yeah, K-State under Ron Prince is doing a great job of finishing and fighting hard.
There's one thing you're going to get from them. They're going to fight hard, and you're going to have to battle them to the end.
Gut check Saturday, tied at 14. How about Wisconsin and Illinois? And Rashard Mendenhall, 32 yards. They strike first.
You know, Mendenhall is what makes this offense go, along with that, you know, sensational sophomore quarterback, Williams. Mendenhall is one of the top running backs you don't hear about.
Juice Williams only hitting 53% of his passes, looking deep. Dumps it off to his fullback, Russ Wye. And nice catch. And leads to a touchdown, 17-0, Fighting Illini. And then here comes Tyler Donovan, finally, trying to get something going for the Badgers.
Travis Beckham, the tight end. That's why he's one of the top tight ends in the country. Great concentration, never takes his eye off the ball. It was an interception, but he keeps his eye on the ball, and that's what allows him to bring the reception in.
17-6, and of course, I don't want to sit here and talk about gambling, but we are talking about the number five team in the country. Not the 25th ranked team, the number five team in the country, Wisconsin. They go in as the underdog. You're not going to see that every day.
You're not, but the reason why is Ron Zook is doing such a great job in preparing this young Illinois team, not only preparing them, but allowing them, putting them in positions to make big plays. Juice Williams, the quarterback, you saw the nice touch pass to his fullback. That shows the maturity that he has. And also, with Rashard Mendenhall in the backfield, they're really balancing it out well. And you know, my guy, the freshman of the year, really has been. He hasn't came alive yet, but believe me, before the day's over, he's going to make a big play.
Still a half to go, and a win in Illinois, 5-1. Okay, West Virginia trying to bounce back after their trip down to Tampa last week. Patrick White ran for 247 last year. Here he pitches to the big fullback, Owen Schmidt. He gets in for the touchdown. And, hey, that's pretty cool that they let the fullback take it in on the option play. Robinson's tip picked off by Dykes. He takes it in for a score.
Keelan Dykes, a big nose tackle. I know that's going to be the highlight of his year, getting in the end zone.
Now Schmidt on the receiving end. Takes it up, finds a seam, 32 yards, leads to a touchdown and a 28-7 lead.
I like that they're showing the versatility. You know, the Pat White and Steve Slayton show, that's not all they have.
White, I mentioned 247, four touchdowns last year against Syracuse. 10 for 12, throwing 125 already. And you see 12 rushes, 60 yards, and a touchdown. Matt Ryan, he's been on fire, 11 300-yard game. Andre Callender takes it in the score. It's 38-10 BC.
Ryan's goal is to develop highly specific anti-cancer drugs. As an undergraduate chemistry major, he's already won two national awards for research, a Goldwater Scholarship and an award from the American Chemical Society.
My student Amanda takes full advantage of our proximity to Boston as an intern with the state Supreme Judicial Court. A promising young historian, Amanda's an invaluable undergraduate research fellow and editor of a campus newspaper.
I'm Ryan Heaney.
I'm Amanda Matthews. We're students at Boston College.
Are you a senior living alone? If you fell or had an emergency, how would you get help? Among seniors, falls are the leading cause of death by injury. That's why there's the Phillips Lifeline Medical Alert Service. If you need help, just push your Lifeline personal help button for quick assistance.
This is Melanie at Lifeline. Do you need help?
I don't think I can stand up.
Do you need an ambulance?
I don't think so. Could you please call my daughter?
Mrs. Simmons?
She's on her way.
Lifeline can give you the confidence to live safely and independently in your own home.
If it hadn't been for the Lifeline and the help coming when it did, I wouldn't be here today.
Call 1-800-396-3535 to receive your free information kit and ask about free activation. Call 1-800-396-3535 now. That's 1-800-396-3535.
Off to Bloomington, Indiana, where the Hoosiers look towards a 5-1 start. Kellen Lewis, his 15th scoring strike, the eighth time, finding James Hardy at 7-0 Hoosiers on top. Adam Weber, nice fake here. It looks like Rex Kern back in the days of the Buckeyes of the 60s. Faked out the cameraman, takes it in for the equalizer, tied at 7. And Brian Payton comes right back for the touchdown. Wow.
What a great hole he just took advantage of and exploded for the touchdown.
14-7, fourth and goal. Gophers, Dwayne Bennett pounds his way in, driving the pile. It's 27-14, Indiana on top in Bloomington. How about Mike Hart, 33 yards shy of Anthony Thomas's all-time rushing record? Well, he picked it up in the first half. Here's a 14-yard gain here, and he eventually becomes Michigan's all-time rushing leader.
You know, Henny looks like he's getting his rhythm back. Great post route to Adrian Arrington right there. Look at the height advantage. Great catch. Touchdown.
Kind of the forgotten man for Michigan receiving corps last year. Hart to 4 yards. Rushing crown. Another touchdown for him. 16-8 Michigan by only 8 over Eastern Michigan. 38 points for BC.
Now, Jamie Silva's leading the BC defense in tackles, but today he also has 2 touchdowns. This one's 65 yards for the touchdown, BC.
I've always wanted to have a pool. To me, that was my dream.
If you've ever dreamed of the perfect swim, for exercise, fun with your family, or relaxation at the end of the day, order a free DVD or video to learn more about the endless pool, your personal pool at home.
Nice and small, compact.
A regular pool, first of all, you have turns that you have to concentrate on. Here, it's endless. You're swimming in place, which is a great opportunity to be able to work on your stroke technique.
It's in your basement. Run downstairs, turn it on, you're there. Like having a treadmill in your basement.
You know, I'll come downstairs and there'll be sometimes 7 or 8 kids in the pool and they're always grabbing onto the bar, cranking it all the way up.
Indoors or outside.
Call 800-319-9796 or visit our website for a free DVD.
Dedication. Hard work. While always looking to the future.
That's what makes an ACC student athlete me.
Developing the best of myself to become a better person. Making it all come together. Achieving, preparing for tomorrow. Then it hit me. I'm also preparing for the rest of my life.
The Atlantic Coast Conference, striving for tomorrow, today.
Number 7, Boston College 38, Bowling Green 10, as we're moments away from the start of the second half. And with 6 minutes to go in the second quarter, it was 21-10 BC, Bowling Green with the football, but then it just comes unglued for the Falcons as Sheehan throws 4 straight interceptions. This one, a 65-yard return by Silva for the touchdown, and it just got worse for Tyler Sheehan, coach.
Well, yeah, it's not only turnovers, it's opportunities that Bowling Green can't squander, but then turnovers for touchdowns. There are 2 touchdowns on the turnover. That's even certainly more critical. Really not getting the pressure. He's really pretty well protected. I think the Bowling Green offensive line has done a pretty good job. They just have to settle down with their offense and play.
Here's a look at our Oxy first half stats. And Gerard, the only thing that stands out there really, the turnovers. Otherwise, Bowling Green was doing just fine.
They're doing a great job, I think, executing their offense. But except for these mistakes that turn the ball over and go the other way for touchdowns, it throws you completely out of your game plan. They're going to have to start moving the ball, throwing the ball downfield a little bit more. And as is, Tyler Sheehan, you know, takes some risks with the ball. And you know, unfortunately, the medicine that's killed him is the medicine that's going to save him.
Well, Matt Ryan and the Boston College offense will have the football first here to start the second half.
Well, I think you'll see this. Steve Logan, he's going to, again, keep the accelerator going. He's not going to let up. I think Steve Logan coached in the game in East Carolina that scored 61 points and lost. So he knows about offense.
Jeff Smith lets it go through the back of the end zone. And Matt Ryan and company will have it first down at 10 from the 20. Now, the Eagles can become bowl eligible with win today. They've gone to 8 straight bowl games. As you mentioned in the first half, Larry, they've won 7 in a row. But the goal is different this year, guys, for the BC Eagles. It's not just to go to a bowl game. It's to get to a BCS game, perhaps play for a national championship. The winner of the ACC goes to the Orange Bowl, and they haven't been to the Orange Bowl since, what, the 40s?
They've been a game away the last 2 years. To make it to a New Year's Day bowl game. And a lot of these guys, the senior leadership guys, really believe that this is their year. They have to go out and take it now. As a matter of fact, Coach, one of the first things that Coach said to this team as he addressed them when he came out as head coach was, this is your year, guys. This is the year that it's going to happen.
Well, I like the thing you see with Matt Ryan, too. You mentioned earlier in the broadcast, Gerard, about him with the meeting, with the team, these senior kids. They're taking ownership of this football team. That means a lot.
Plus, they're good players.
Ryan goes to Andre Callender. What a first half for Callender. And one rushing touchdown, two receiving. John Hainlein makes the tackle there. But Callender, of course, that big 51-yard play. A short dump pass, and then it's all Callender after that.
He's an exceptional talent, and we were talking to Steve Logan about him before the game, and Steve was trying to get him, you know, you got to make a play for us. You got to break out, and this is the kind of thing that's going to give you confidence. So once you break one, you feel a little bit more of the defense, and you have more of an opportunity to break another one. And then he gets this little flare pass out here, keeps himself in bounds. You know, one of the things that's so good about him, he's got wonderful body control, and then on top of that, a nice little surge into the end zone here.
Callender coming off a career-high 32 carries last week against UMass. He had 115 yards and a couple of touchdowns. Well, in the first half, he had 49 yards on the ground, the one rushing touchdown, and he had 79 receiving yards and two touchdowns. So it was very balanced as far as Callender was concerned. Third down and two for Boston College. Heisman hopeful Matt Ryan throws it out. And it's caught for a first down. It was Callender, a 5-yard pickup, and first down 10 for BC.
Actually, motion Callender out to actually line him up at a wide receiver position. And you don't, again, I'm very impressed with the poise of a.